My life as a teenage robot is another show that I completely skipped on over these last 2 years. Other than the YouTube tribute that I made 3 months ago, I haven't made a review of this show, loving the episodes, in about almost 3 years. As far as I'm concerned, I really need to get my priorities straight whenever I think about reviewing these shows in the distant future. But at least this is the time to do it. A Robot for All Seasons begins with Jenny being the robotic Santa, sending all the presents to everyone throughout the entire world, and all because she's completely faster than Santa. And the only reason why she completely did those deliveries is because Santa Claus is completely injured due to a sledding accident. When Jenny and her friends get to the mall and want to do some Christmas shopping, Jenny come across Todd, who is going to be the main character of this episode. And he's completely miserable because he didn't get what he wanted for Christmas. And Jenny, being the lighthearted girl that she is during this time of the show, becomes a gift, and somehow Todd was able to purchase him at the mall. And then when they completely went outside, Jenny knows that Todd actually has a limo and he's actually famous. Mainly because he's actually a little kid and his parents are always busy. And keep that in mind, they're always, always busy. Jenny gets to Todd's place. As it turns out, Todd has so many weapons and he really wants something from Christmas. And that's a missile. Yeah, a huge missile. And considering that he didn't get what he wants, he decides to cause a lot of bad luck to so many people all over this entire planet involving the Christmas season. So he completely uses an antenna on Jenny, which actually gives him mind control, and it's actually been a year. Yeah, it's been a year since the events when Jenny completely got mind controlled. When Jenny returns back home, all the other people are going against her. Why? Because in the other holidays involving Halloween, the 4th of July, and Valentine's Day, Jenny does whatever she can because of the antenna that she has on her head controlled by Todd, is ruining all the holiday joy involving so many people in her home. And in all honesty, I really think that really goes to show on to why it's been a long year in order to make this setting of Christmas work in the show. Granted that this episode isn't canon, but I'll get to that later. Should probably talk about Todd and his motivation. Granted, it's the same motivation I've seen from the Drake and Josh movie, but I really think that he went a lot more farther than he used to. Unlike in the Drake and Josh movie, where the villain is just spreading bad luck on Drake and Josh during the Christmas season, he's completely putting a lot of bad luck on so many people all over the world. And I really think that's pretty much the issue on why people have against it. What people have against this episode is because of Todd. You know, I would understand that his motivations are something that people usually do in these styles of Christmas, but when you completely put a lot of stress on so many people, in not just in Christmas, but in other holidays, it really makes your motivations really meaningless, especially that all the stuff that Todd went through was during the Christmas seasons, not in any other holiday. Even at the end of the episode, when they completely stop Todd, he doesn't get any punishment whatsoever. I mean, I can understand that this is something that he needs to learn to understand what the meaning of Christmas is, but when you literally look at him completely causing a lot of stress and so much bad luck on so many people throughout these entire years, it really makes the stress of what Jenny went through completely justified and not in a more serious fashion. As far as I'm concerned, this is pretty much onto the reasons onto why I think that this episode isn't really canon, because they pretty much try everything they can to make this episode a bit unique, but at the same time, due to so many painful ideals that they had to go through in the production of this episode and then just pulling them at the finished product, I think they want to have this episode not be existed because they really made Jenny really bad when it comes to her getting controlled by Todd by ruining so many holidays. And the fact that people are going against her in the next Christmas, I really think that I can understand onto why this episode isn't really canon. But to give this episode some kind of credit, they gave Sheldon, who has a crush on Jenny, have some kind of role that the fact that he never gives up on Jenny no matter what. He completely tells Jenny that throughout these last 12 months that she was causing a lot of chaos throughout the entire holidays. And the fact that all the people are ganging up and want to be her, except that Sheldon's literally the only one, it's literally the only way to have this episode really work and to have the plot continue on in some other way. And I really think that's pretty much one of the moments that I actually enjoyed from this episode. And when Jenny gives Sheldon a kiss because of what he did in this episode, it's actually kind of a great moment involving shipping fans who ship Sheldon and Jenny together. It's just a shame that this episode isn't really canon. What do I think about this episode? Well, it tries to do this unique idea by involving the story of a person not getting what he wants and just decide to have bad luck going on to other people. They probably went a little too far with that. At least Chuck and Joss had a limitation involving the villain, but this, I really think they probably want to make Jenny miserable by having her on the wand, but at the same time, it just really doesn't work when you have a villain just causing a lot of situations in other holidays and not just in Christmas. I mean, that's pretty much the only thing that really makes this episode work, because if they can completely continue this on with so many years while having the other characters getting older, and the fact that XJ10, invented by Jenny's mom, was going to be a thing, I really think that probably won't work, so they decide to have a one-year gap in order to make the plot of this story work, which is actually probably the situation that they had to deal with. They really don't know how to easily continue this. They really don't know how to continue the plot of this unless if they have the other holidays terrible for so many people. For me personally, this episode didn't bother me a lot because they actually made the characters have some kind of a serious battle against Jenny, mainly her friends. And I really think that the moments between Jenny and the other characters in this, it may be a bit too far with the betrayal, but you can understand the emotions of what Jenny went through. When you see the scene between her and her mother and her going to tears and the fact that she's using her own weapons against her, it really makes it a really great moment to actually see something like this involving a show like, involving a cartoon like this. Something that you would probably expect from a serious 44-minute episode, but since that this is a Christmas special, they probably want to use these ideas for this episode. In my opinion on this episode, I wouldn't recommend watching it because you might be able to be either mad or really happy with it, but as far as I'm concerned, if you're really interested into watching this episode, I recommend watching some kind of reviews and some kind of thoughts from some other people before you watch this episode for your own opinion and judgment. This episode is pretty much the most different episode I've ever seen involving Jenny in the situation that she got herself into, but what Todd got herself into. I really think that this is pretty much an episode that would either be a different opinion based on if this is a good episode or a bad episode. In my opinion, it's somewhat in the middle, but at the same time, I still think that this episode could have been a lot more better than what we originally got. I give this episode a 6.5 out of 10. Haven't given these types of ratings in a long time. Granted that this episode actually deserves a rating like that.